Hi, this video is on z-scores or standard scores and percentiles and how the percentiles relate to the z-scores for a normal distribution. And if you need this worksheet, you know, you can get it on my website at caroleemath.com. Okay, so let's talk about z-scores, also sometimes called standard scores. What it is, it's the number of standard deviations that a value is away from the mean. And there's a formula for it. Z is the x, which is the data value, minus the mean over the standard deviation. Okay, what does that all mean? Let's use our height of 10-year-old example, and I'm gonna calculate a few z-scores so you can see what's going on here. Let's start with this middle. Let's just say the mean height, well, we know the mean height's 55. Let's find the z-score for this value. So I'm gonna go up here. Z equals, x is the particular value that we're calculating it for, so I'll do 55 in this case, minus the mean, which is 55, over the standard deviation, which is 6 inches in our example here. Now that is 0 divided by 6, or 0. So what that's saying is someone with a height of 55, a 10-year-old with a height of 55, is 0 inches away from the mean. They're right on the mean. And so we're gonna change this to a 0. This is a standard normal. There's no reason that it's smaller other than just to fit more on the page. I could have made it the exact same width. Standard normal is, we use the letter Z in statistics to represent that. Okay, so the mean is now, see how it turned into 0? Because we subtracted the mean from it. Okay, let's try 61. Let's find the z-score for 61. We take the value minus the mean, which is 55, over the standard deviation, which is 6. Okay, 61 minus 55, that is 6 away because it is one standard deviation away. So we get 6 over 6, which is 1. So what that says is 61 is one standard deviation away from the mean. All right, what do you think it would be for 67 and 73? You want to try it? If you want to try it, pause the video and try it out. Okay, so a 67 would come out to be two standard deviations above the mean. It would be 67 minus 55, so that's 12 divided by 6 is 2. And 73, the z-score will be 3 because it's 3 standard deviations above the mean. Cool, huh? That's the way the z-score is set up, to always make this come out to 0, 1, 2, 3. What about on the left side? Let's do 49. 49 minus 55 over 6. Okay, this is also 6 away, but it's in the negative direction. So we have, we're subtracting 55, so that's negative 6 over 6, or negative 1. So we get a negative z-score if we're to the left of the mean. This will be negative 2. And I ran a little bit over into my space there. That is negative 3, where 37 is 3 standard deviations below the mean. So when you hear a z-score, that tells you how far someone is away from the mean. It also tells you whether they're above average or below average, because to the right is going to be a positive z-score, and to the left is going to be a negative z-score. Okay, so let's do an example where we find the z-score for a 10-year-old with a height of 52 inches. So z equals x minus the mean, just gonna write the formula down, over the standard deviation. And that is our value, is what we're looking for, that particular person, 52 inches. Minus the mean is 55 over the standard deviation, of 6. It's getting dark outside. I don't know if you can tell on the video. It just feels like it's getting really, really dark. Really fast. Okay, so let's look at where 52 is. Do you want to take a guess at what you think the z-score will be? Let's find, where's 52? It's right here. It's between 49 and 55. Okay, so if we subtract these, that's 3 away. So negative 3 over 6, it's negative 1/2 or negative 0.5. That fits with where that point is. What that says is it's half a standard deviation below the mean. So this particular 10-year-old is a little bit shorter than average, but they're half a standard deviation below the mean. They're still within, a lot of people are within 68%, we know, are within one standard deviation on either side. Okay, so to write our interpretation, we would say this 10-year-old is half a standard deviation, or we could have said 0.5 standard deviations. Below the mean. The units on the z-score, you see how we have inches over inches, so they cancel each other out? I like to think of the units on the z-score as actual standard deviations. I don't think I can fit it, so I'm gonna abbreviate. Standard deviations. Okay, so that's how you calculate a z-score. It's by taking whatever value they give us, subtract the mean, and divide by the standard deviation. It works no matter what your mean and standard deviation are. That will center everything at 0 and give you, turn it into 1, 2, 3, and negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. Okay, so let's look at percentiles now. I'm going to move this up. You might have heard of percentiles of height and weight, especially for babies and young kids, they do that. You might have heard of percentiles in terms of test scores, scoring on a certain percentile on the SATs or another type of standardized test. So it's easiest to show you with a picture here. Here we have a normal curve. And percentile is different than percentage. Okay, you have a good idea what percentage means. So let's say we're taking the 70th percentile. That means if you scored, let's say on a test, if you scored on the 70th percentile, that means 70% of the people scored less than you did, and 30% scored higher. So the 70th percentile is actually the test score, or it might be a height. So it's not a percentage, it's the actual value that that percentage scored below you. Someone who's in the 70th percentile for weight means 70% of the people, 70% of the population weigh less than that person, whatever that weight is. Same thing for height. 70th percentile means 70% of the people are shorter than that height. Okay, so the X percentile, just any percentile, is the value that that percent of the data values are below. It always goes to the left. It always goes below. Okay, so let's try one out here. Still got our 10-year-olds in the normal curve. A 10-year-old is in the 86th percentile in height. This means the child is taller than what percent of the 10-year-olds? Now these are always going to match. They're taller than 86% of the 10-year-olds. So if I draw a little, small picture here. We're still saying this is normally distributed because we're following our same example. But this time, instead of 70%, it's going to be 86% over here. And we don't know yet what height that is, but we could figure it out. I guess we could, for right now, we only have the empirical rule, so we could only figure it out if that height was on one of the even standard deviations. Okay, now one thing to watch out for is what if they said this means the child is shorter than what percentage? So they can flip the question in terms of making it, taller means it's to the left, shorter means it's to the right. So in this example, 86% is to the left or shorter. Yes, because the child is taller than 86%. So the child would be shorter than what percent? Let's answer that one. So 100% is the total. What's the complement of that? Or 100 minus 86, 14%. So this would be 14%. So the question, so we could say the 10-year-old is shorter than 14% of 10-year-olds. So that's something to watch out for. Just be sure you're answering it in the correct direction of the graph. Okay, so that's what percentiles mean. And we're going to compare now, see how percentiles and z-scores relate to each other. Down at the bottom here, it says use the empirical rule to find percentiles. Okay, so we've got our z-scores. Our z-scores are standard scores. I'll write these in from our graph above. We know 0 is in the middle, and it goes up 1, 2, 3, and negative 1, negative 2, negative 3 to the left. Okay, let's start at the very left. So the percentile, remember, would be what percentage of people are 3 standard deviations or below 3 standard deviations from the mean. Now we calculated that number. That was 0.0015. And so the percentile would be, we're gonna need to move the decimal over 0.15. I don't even know how you say that. It's not the 15th percentile, it's the 0.15 percentile. Might make a little more sense when we get a little bigger numbers. Okay, that's because that's the percentage that's below that value. Whatever it is, if it's 3 standard deviations below the mean, it's that percentile. Okay, let's go 2 standard deviations below the mean. So we had this value was 0.0235. So we need to add these together. So 0.015 plus 0.235. Okay, 0.025. So let's move this over. Okay, 2.5th percentile. 2.5th percentile. Like, it's hard to say when it's a decimal. You see what we're going to do next? Negative 1, we want to know what percentage is below this value of negative 1, and that's the percentile. So this area, or this probability, is 0.135. So we could just take our number and add it on. There's that number 16 again. So that's the 16th percentile. And that means if someone is 1 standard deviation below the mean, let's put it in context. Let's say a 10-year-old is 1 standard deviation below the mean in height. That means they're taller than 16% of the 10-year-olds. Okay, here's a big question for you. What's the percentile going to be at zero, a z-score of zero. Do you know without calculating it? You can pause it if you want to think about it for a minute. We know this is 0.34, but without calculating it, I want you to see that this is half. And so that is the 50th percentile. Okay, now if we add those together, it should come up to 0.5, right? Let's do it. I have to make sure I do it with the decimals in the correct place. What's going on? Okay, sorry, I did it wrong. Let's just need to take the 16 that we already had. I was trying to add them all up. Plus the 16 that we already had, plus the 34. That is our 50. Okay, you probably did that better than I did. Okay, now we're just adding on here. This one was also 0.34. So what would that percentile be of this one standard deviation above the mean? It's going to be 50 plus 0.34, so 84. So someone who's one standard deviation above the mean in height is taller than 84% of the people, the 10-year-olds. Okay, two more. This one is the next one. It's the mirror image of this, so 0.135. So I'm going to add 84 plus 13.5, 97.5 percentile. And then we need to add another 0.0235. It's not quite 100%, right? Because we have this little itty bit over here. So this one is going to be 97.5 plus 2.35. Oops, can't see that. 97.5 plus 2.35. 99.85. Okay, someone who is three standard deviations above the mean is very tall, right? That's almost as tall as you can be. Someone, it's very rare. Two is an outlier. It's very rare to be three standard deviations above the mean. You can see the probability is very, very low. And so someone who is three standard deviations above the mean is in the 99.85th percentile. So that means they are taller than all these people. They're taller than 99.85% of the people. Okay, so I hope that gives you a good idea about z-scores, how to calculate them. The z-score is always the number minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. That tells us how many standard deviations away from the mean that value is. And then the percentile, whatever the value is, it tells us what percentage they are above or what percentage is below them. And then we took our z-scores and found the percentile for each z-score. So we'll be using those in class. And I will see you then.